thing called tuna sashimi. 3, 2, 1.
Hello, Tunia, back again. This time I'm going to do a bit of a review of Shovel Knight. This is the Wii U version, but as far as I know, all versions are pretty much the same. So, say this is a classic platform game done in the sort of old school sort of NES sort of 8-bit graphics, but this game is done very well indeed. It's very good, plays exceptionally well, and it's very, you know, it's praised by a lot of websites, to be honest. And I did leave it a while before I actually played it, because I actually bought the disc bought for me for Christmas. And as soon as I started playing, I ended up playing all the way through it, because it's such a good game. But it's proper old school sort of difficulty. It's not too difficult. A lot of people say it's really hard. I was expecting it to be a lot harder than it was, to be honest. But still doesn't mean it's easy. It's still a bit of a challenge, you know. Say they do speed run this game quite often as well. Speed runs are pretty amazing on this game, especially the Plague Knight speed runs. I'll come to that after I've showed you the main game. But anyway, say what you get is your normal start game. There's a few options you got. You got challenge mode, which I haven't actually done any of these challenge. That unlocks, I think, once you actually complete the game. You got feats, which pretty much just shows all the stuff you've done in the game as Shovel Knight. And you've got your user options, you know, game controls, that type thing, you know, nothing too crazy. So we'll start a game. Let's say this is a classic 2D sort of platform game. As you can see, I've completely debited and I've got all my upgrades, so we'll have a go at that. I don't want to start New Game Plus. I say you're given a classic map screen, a bit like the Mario games, which is pretty cool, and you open levels as you go along. Although these are locked up until you've done certain levels, and then they start opening up, and then the map gets bigger and bigger, and you can pick your levels you want to go to. But what we'll do, I'll run through the first level, and then we'll explain how the controls work. Well, you've got amiibo support as well. I've actually got the Shovel Knight amiibo, which is pretty cool. So as it says on the tin, you've got a knight with a shovel. You can basically do a down attack. You don't press a button for that, you actually just hold down. You can do a normal shovel attack. That fireball you see there is a bit of an upgrade. You don't normally get that from the start. So basically you hit things, you get diamonds, you use diamonds for buying items and equipment. So basically you run your way through the level. See, it's got some clever mechanics in this. The jumping down mechanic, like I'll do it on this. That mechanic is used a fair amount for the entire game, and it's done really well. So this game plays really tight. It plays like an old classic 2D game, really. Like, it plays really nice playability on it. It's got loads of secrets as well. There's a lot of stuff to find. You've got to bounce off the bubbles there. When you go through the levels, you find these things by here. You can walk past them, and these are like restart points, basically. But you can hit them for extra points. You can break them. If it will break, of course. No, maybe it won't break. But you can break them. I don't know why that one's not breaking. But you don't really want to do that, because the reset point, unless you're confident in your skills of going through the level, but the restart points are very useful to have. It's one-hit deaths as well, so if you do hit those spikes, it's game over. This guy, quite nice, he just bounced on his head, poor bugger. What you don't actually have to hold down for that bounce attack, you just initiate it by pulling down. You've got to be careful, some platforms you can actually break. So you've got to press the shovel button, will actually cancel out of it. So later on that becomes a very, very useful thing to do. Because you will end up sort of breaking through platforms and falling to your death. I'm not sure if there's any secrets on this first level. But you usually find them in walls like that there. So as you can see, the graphics in this game are really nice. It's a really pretty game. It's for you know, obviously 2D 8-bit graphics, like. But this is something you might have seen on the NES. Obviously, a little bit nicer than the NES. That but there is a music note. If you collect those music notes and go and see the sage in the town, you'll play the soundtrack for you and you can choose what music you want to play when you're in the town, which is pretty cool. There was a secret but there as well. There on the wall. Yeah, but this is something you would have expected on an NES or something, like a really well-made game on the NES. Like I say, the soundtrack to this as well is fantastic. I really do like the soundtrack of this game. It's done by Jake, I can't remember his last name now. Same guy did Mighty Switch Force and Shanty and the Pirate's Curse. It's also another really good game as well. There's a secret there. Benji. So you've got some really nice tunes this. I say at the end of each level you fight a boss, and there's multiple bosses, and there's like little sub bosses that pop up, like Mario 3D style, will pop up on the levels, so you can choose whether to attack them or not. So you can choose to go over there. There is actually a secret over there. You can see on the wall. Another one of those music notes. It's a bit greyed out because I've already got it. But it will allow you to go back into the secrets. Having lots of cash in this game is also very useful. Especially for upgrading your armour. You get different armors that allows you to do different things. It's a pretty cool idea in there, a knight with a shovel. But it actually works like. Yeah. They say you can go back through each level and hog the points if you want to, like, which is, it is handy. Especially if you're saving up for that shovel upgrade or something like that, or you know, you want a new set of armor. I don't know whether you can see it, it's sparkling on the left. You get these things everywhere, these little sparkle things, so so you can either call up the menu like this, or you can use the Wii U pad to do it. So basically you want the I don't want the phone anchor, I want the fishing rod. We're using it. Sit. If you press the button when you hear that, you can get different power-ups and various other things as you go through the levels, actually. So there's a lot of power-ups you can find. A lot of interesting weapons as well. He's a bit silly, isn't he? I say the actual platforming on this as well is extremely tight. So it is very well made. Never see a good bit. Is another secret over there as well. Ah, that just gives me another music note, but you're going to use this guy actually to get over there. We'll go over there just to show you, why not? It's definitely worth finding these secrets. for the extra money you get, the music notes, and there's quite a lot of collectibles. I don't think I've got them all. This is the first boss coming up here. So you can attack him with this, but I find a lot of the bosses you can quick kill him if you can trap him in the corner. There is techniques to quick killing bosses, which I'm not doing anywhere. So the first boss is pretty easy anyway. You need to use a lot of the tactics on the harder bosses later on in the game. Well, so that's the first stage. So once you've done the first stage, you can you get to the village. So you can talk to people, buy items, and there's the sage I was talking about. If you speak to him, you can get music notes and various other things, and he gives you money for them, which is quite cool. There's some strange people in this town, mind. This guy here, this will extend your energy bar and your magic bar. There's different types of magic. They do various different things. The punch one is quite useful. You've got fireballs and various other things. But if I can find it, the one I used to find useful most often is this one. This one turns you, invisible. So you're basically invulnerable for a small amount of time. These are all people you unlock during the game. This guy over here sells you weapons and various upgrades, but you've got to find him in the levels to get it. And there's various, there's a mini game over there as well. But they say the little couple of seconds of invincibility is really, really useful. Oh, that's something you unlock later on, which takes you to the other village on the map. And there's various things to do here. This is where you can get your upgrades. This guy sells armor. So your armors and your weapons here. So it's the different armors, they do different things, but to be honest, the red armor, that's quite useful. Basically, that's the one I ended up using most of the time, to be honest. And when you die, you lose gold and money. With our one, you lose half the amount. You can go back to where you died and collect the gold again. But I say most of the time, that was the one I used. Same with weapon upgrades. You can buy all them. I don't think it's going to let me because I've already got them all. So basically the other town is there on the map. They say there's various bosses, there's a lot of secret stuff to do, like for there, and it's a fairly big game as well. It took me a little while to finish it, and it gets harder and harder as you play it. And there's a classic, you've got a boss battle at the end where you fight all the bosses again, and you do various things like that. The Iron Wheel. Let's go to that level. Actually, that's Plague Knight's level. Plague Knight is one of the bosses in this game. When you actually complete the game, you can download... it was an updated boss. They give you Plague Knight as a playable character. And once you've got that character, the game is completely different, essentially. Basically, how the game is played, it's radically different to as it was, which is pretty cool for a free upgrade. So once you actually finish the main game, Plague Knight is the boss in this level. You get to use Plague Knight, and I'll show you him in a minute. See, this is where more tactics come in. So this game just gives you more and more sort of things. You get things, you've got to fly through the air, you get the exploding like rats you've got here as well, and you know, there's fire on the floors. It's a really clever game, like. But like I say, if you use that skill that I've got there, you're pretty much invincible for a couple of seconds, which is well handy. And it also tends to be at the top of the screen. Some of them you can actually jump on top, like sort of Super Mario Brothers, and you can go across, and there's secrets up there. So apart from making this video incredibly long, we'll go back to the title screen. I tell you, they changed the buttons around in this. It's B to select instead of A, which sort of does throw you off a little bit, to be honest. Right. So there's Plague Knight. I haven't done a huge amount with Plague Knight. I've only unlocked a few things. Plague Knight is quite funny, because when you go to the town, you're not actually allowed in the town. Because he's one of the bosses, it chucks you out. But there's like a secret town underneath, which is quite cool. But I say this was free DLC. If you buy the disc of the game now, you actually get this DLC actually on the disc, which is pretty cool. But other than that, as far as I know, it is a free download. So, well, we'll go to this level. And I'll show you the tactics with Plague Knight. Right, completely different. This makes the game completely different. He's got basically a double jump to kill with Plague Knight. You got to chuck bombs at him. Plus bombs, if you hold down the bomb button and let go of it, you do like a big jump. So you go, you can like do a boost jump. But this really does change the game up completely. It feels like a completely different game, to be honest. Because you've got to use various tactics now to get over a lot of this stuff. He's got completely different weapons as well. He can get, gets like sort of, ooh, what the hell. You get like different weapons, and now you get double shots and big explosions and all that sort of thing with him. So, like I said, I haven't done a huge amount with Plague Knight, because it is pretty difficult, Plague Knight, but it's pretty cool how they've managed to sort of give you a completely different character with this game to play all the way through, and how different it actually feels. The boss tactics are completely different. Like, to get up there, I got a charge, jump, and boost. There's a secret up there as well. Learning how to control that boost jump is how to play this game. Really cool music on this level as well. You can sort of jump over him with Plague Knight as well. Like that. Secret, but yeah. We've got to watch as well. If you want to jump over platforms, you can double jump and then press fire, and you will do a float. Won't go over there because it's difficult. I haven't got much energy. Trying to find the jump. Like I said, I'm not that great with Plague Knight, so it definitely takes quite a bit of practice to get good at him. You gotta watch that boost jump, because it does really sort of depend on the angle you use in that boost jump. It does throw you out. This is one of the elements of this game. Oh, Plague Knight's dead. The background goes dark. The boss is quite hard to fight. See, this is where you actually lose the, your money. See, if you get back to it, you can pick it back up. I'm going to boost over this guy. I say this game is, I've seen some really amazing speedruns on this game. Like, if you check out Video Games Done Quick. The summer Video Games Done Quick actually is coming up in July, and where they play pretty much 24 hours, 7 days a week, for 1 week, speedruns on all games, new games, old games. And they do it for charities, normally cancer charities they normally do it for. So it's cool to support, and the last couple of years they've made over $1 million, or $1 million, which is pretty amazing. And it's usually a pretty awesome watch as well. But watch for there's gaps in the floor. Here's another secret there. I won't go down there because there's another one of those music notes which I don't need. Seems there's a secret to the left as well. This is quite an interesting little game mechanic. That guy's helmet is really heavy, so when you're on it and the helmet goes, it knocks it down. Gotta watch for you don't jump too high here, because those spikes will take you out. Those coins you need to collect with Plague Knight as well. It's hard, a lot hard work with the background going black. So what you got to do on this one is knock this skull, well, this helmet up here. Cool. Nice. So there's another secret over to the left there, but I'll just get to the boss and then we'll end this video, I think. And give this game a score. So you can, as you can see with this game, the graphics are wicked, really cool. It is an extremely well made game, and to be honest, I don't really know what other games this company's actually made. I think it's down there, I gotta go. Quite handy with Plague Knight, the way you can boost over everything. This bit's going to be tricky with him. This bit's going to be hard. Thank you. Oh, damn. I hate that one ghost along the way. Anyway, guys, I think we'll leave that video there, so it's getting a bit long. Say, Shovel Knight, you can get it on pretty much everything. PCs, PS4s. I'm not sure if it came out on the 360. It might have. I think it's come out on a hell of a lot of machines. It is a fantastic game. Really good indeed. Really enjoyed playing it all the way through. And especially with the free downloadable content, the Plague Knight, which changes up this game completely and just turns it into a completely different game, essentially. Fantastic game, and you know, I'm tempted to give this 10 out of 10, to be honest, but I'm going to give it 9.5, because this game is pretty awesome, and you know, if you're into these type of games, platforms and everything, and you know, you like the older retro games, which is probably why you're watching my channel, go out and buy yourself Shovel Knight. You won't regret it. Very good game indeed, and you'll really enjoy playing through it. So, I said we'll give it 9.5, we're going to leave the video there, so hope you enjoyed, guys, and then that was Shovel Knight on the Wii U, so I'll catch you next time with something different. Bye now.